Hi there, boys and girls. I trust that you're well and that you've got back into going to school and getting back into, just almost normal again, whatever that might be. Today's story, we continue in the book of John and we're considering who Jesus is. We're looking at his life, his stories, what he taught us, what he showed us. And by doing that, we're getting to know a little bit more about Jesus. And maybe for some of you, you're changing your perspective on who he is. You're looking at him differently. You said to him, gee whiz, I didn't realize this part about him, or I didn't realize he taught that or he did that. And that's what this whole study is all about, is allowing you to look at Jesus with new eyes, having your eyes opened up and realizing that the one who performed all these miracles and taught these awesome truths is actually the Son of God, the Messiah that the prophets foretold in the future and long ago in the Old Testament, that he really was the Messiah. Today's story happens in Canaan. Now, some of you have heard that name before. Where could you have heard the name Canaan before? Well, let me give you a little clue. It was the first miracle Jesus did. Some of you know exactly which one it is. It's the miracle where Jesus changed water into wine. Remember, he went to the wedding and they ran out of wine. He said, bring the water and I'll change it into wine. And that's what he did. That's what happened in Canaan. He's back in Canaan now after traveling around. And as he's walking, an official, a royal official, he's not even a Jewish gentleman or one of the Jews, approaches him and tells him that his son is busy dying. His son is desperately ill. And he begs Jesus, please come and heal my son. Please, I know you can do this. What faith this man had. Jesus says to him, go, your son is healed. And you know what? The official turns around, leaves. And as the Bible says, that he takes Jesus at his word. He doesn't sit there wrestling with Jesus saying, oh, come on, you've got to go with me. If you're not with me, my son won't be healed. One reads in the Bible that he believed Jesus, believed what he had to say, and he left. And as he goes back home to Capernaum, where he lived, as he arrives home, his people come and tell him, hey, your son is healed. And he says to them, listen here, at what time of the day did he start feeling better? What time of the day was he healed? And you know what's amazing? Was that the time that they told him was the same time Jesus had spoken to him and told him that his son would be healed. That is incredible. That shows that Jesus didn't even have to be in the same room or in the same town as somebody to be able to heal them. And isn't it wonderful to know that we can pray to a God who's in heaven? And we know that even though we don't see him around us, we don't see Jesus walking through our streets here in Durbanville and Cape Town, we can still believe that even though he's not here, in faith we believe that he's able to heal people. He's able to answer our prayers. And that's an incredible encouragement and promise we receive from God's word and this story today. But it made me think, what is faith? I kept using the word faith. Did you notice that? I said to you that that man must have had faith, a belief in God, that even though he couldn't see his son healed, he believed that that was true. Now, faith to me is almost like electricity. When you walk into your house and you go to the light switch, now this is assuming there isn't load shedding, because your Eskom can sometimes make life a bit difficult, but assuming there is electricity. When you walk and before you put your finger onto that switch, you believe that after you've clicked that switch, the lights will come on. You don't see the wiring through the wall. You don't see any of that. You just press the button on the side and the lights come on. Now, faith is like that. The Bible says in Hebrews chapter 11, which is a beautiful chapter to read all about faith. In chapter 11 in the book of Hebrews, it says the following. This is the definition of faith. Now, faith is a confidence in what we hope for. Think of that official. What was he hoping for? He was hoping that his son would be healed. And he had the confidence in Jesus to know that God was capable, God was able to do this. Confidence in what we hope for and the assurance about what we do not see. So when we read God's word and we read the promises, and sometimes when we go through difficult times, we know the Bible says to us that God is with us through everything. And even though we don't see him, and even though we feel all alone, we know that our God, Almighty God, is there with us in every situation. We have the confidence to know and the assurance to know that God is true to his promises and God is real. It says here, this is what the ancients commanded. And then he goes through the whole, in the chapter 11, he goes through this whole thing about what faith is and how these different, what we call them, heroes of the faith, how they trusted God and God came through for them all the time. So sometimes our perspective is there is no God. Sometimes our perspective is God does not care for us. Where is God when it hurts? Where is God when I feel lonely? Where is God when I really need him? The Bible tells us that that's when we have to exercise faith. We have to remind ourselves of what we've read about him in the Word of God. We have to remind ourselves that he loves us, that he cares for us, that he's patient and kind and merciful and all those good things, and that he will never desert nor leave us. And so in that moment when it really feels like we're in a difficult place, we can look up to the heavens, we can look up to the hills, and we can find our strength in God Almighty. So I don't know what you're dealing with at school. I don't know what you're dealing with at home. Maybe you have no real troubles in your life, and that is fantastic. But maybe you are going through difficulties. Maybe you know about people that are going through difficulties. Maybe even during this lockdown, this pandemic, you heard some sad stories and you saw people struggling. Why don't you be an encouragement to them? Why don't you help them change their perspective of their situation so they stop looking at their situation and they start looking up at God, the one who is able to be there for them in all things? So that's the encouragement I'm going to give you today in today's story. Just like the official believed in God and believed God's words to be true, Jesus' words to be true, so we can believe his words to be true. So I want to pray for you right now. So won't you close your eyes and let me pray for you. And loving Father, we thank you, Lord, that in your word we learn that you are a faithful God, that you are, your promises are true. And we thank you, Lord, that we can come to you in all situations in our lives. And we can believe that you are true. We can believe that your promises are true. We can believe that you are trustworthy in all situations. And thank you, Lord, that because we can believe it, we know that we can rest. We can have a peace and a joy. We can even be happy in difficult times, in trying times, because our strength and our hope is not to be found in ourselves. It's not limited to ourselves, but it's to be found in you. Thank you for this story. That's such an encouragement to us. And I pray, Lord, for anyone who's listening today, that they would find strength and encouragement in this message, that they would have the faith of this official as he listened to Jesus and he trusted and believed Jesus' words to be true. Amen. Well, I hope that you enjoy the rest of your week. Can't wait to share another story with you. But keep watching and keep listening to the Perspective series and tell your friends about it. Watch it a second time if you've missed something the first time around. Enjoy the quizzes that we add on to the presentations as well. See if you can do the spot the differences. See if you can do the word searches. But enjoy them. And we're looking forward to seeing you one day at Kids Church where we no longer have this lockdown. But until then, I wish you well. I hope that and pray that you will remain safe and healthy.